Asian markets ended Monday trade on a mixed note as investors braced for central bank decisions this week. Japan's Nikkei 225 slumped nearly 8%, while its 10-year government bond yield soared to an over 10-year high as the Bank of Japan begins its two-day policy meeting. Over in Australia, the ASX 200 fell 0.8% despite data showing retail sales posted a surprise jump in September. Some notable stock movements in the region: shares of China Evergrande tumbled as much as 20% in morning trade as it faced a winding-up hearing in Hong Kong. It pared losses to 9.7% at the close after the court gave the troubled developer a five-week reprieve to come up with a deal with creditors or face liquidation. In Japan, shares of Panasonic closed 2% lower after it trimmed its 2023 fiscal outlook. It also cut its profit guidance for its battery unit, which supplies Tesla. It cited a global slowdown in EV sales. Here at home, the Philippine stock market was closed for the Village and Youth Council polls. BDO Capital's Ed Francisco sees a quiet week ahead, with trading also shortened by the All Souls Day holiday.
The key decision was made already last week by the BSP, right? And then, and anyway, as you know, because it was a long weekend, people already unloaded on their stocks last Friday, and that's why the index fell. And then because it's a short week, I don't anticipate people to go gangbusters and invest. They, to be conservative, you know, the market activity will restart next Monday. That way, at least, you know, they are not going to be surprised by the long weekend if there's going to be problems with Gaza or, as you said, other global news. So very quiet week.
The White House takes a tough stance on safety and security standards for artificial intelligence. U.S. President Joe Biden unveiled on Monday a landmark executive order outlining a comprehensive strategy for AI use. These include standards in protecting the privacy of Americans, promoting innovation and competition, and standing up for consumers. The order comes as AI makes rapid gains in capability and popularity, and limited legislation on its moderation. The UK also taking steps to regulate the technology, with British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak announcing last week that they will set up an AI safety institute. The 2023 Village and Youth Council polls deemed generally peaceful. That's despite reports of at least 4 fatalities and poll-related violence and over 160 vote-buying incidents. The Commission on Elections says it hopes to proclaim winning candidates by 10 to 10:30 p.m. tonight.
Pagka clear na yung smoke, yung lahat ng mga nagkasala, hindi namin patatawarin yun. Alam po namin na lahat ng mga pagkakakilanlan ng mga taong yan, kahit po yung mga taong nakialam at mga politiko na nakialam sa ating halalan, lalo na po dyan sa mga bandang area ng Mindanao. Pabayaan lang po natin, tapusin muna natin yung pagbilang, at kinakailangan ang pinaka-importante pong part ay yung paproklamasyon ng lahat ng kandidato.
Our purpose is clear, and that is to establish a space where the voices of our citizens can reverberate with strength and clarity. And it is our duty to protect the integrity of every vote.
This year also saw the first ever mall voting for the Village and Youth Council polls. The COMELEC partnered with two of the country's largest mall operators for the pilot testing. This is to provide a more convenient way for voting, especially for the vulnerable sector like senior citizens and persons with disabilities.
May mga pinaghanda po kami sa mga pilahan para sa mga senior citizens po natin, mga PWD. May mga priority lanes po kami na inanda din po para sa kanila. Lahat po ng mga facilities po ng mall, like elevator, escalator, yung mga aircon po ng mall, ay binuksan po namin para at least maging magaan, mapabuti po yung election po ng barangay at sa kasangguniang kabataan.